born by cesarean. And there's also a possibility that the firstborn is the one that was born naturally after a cesarean, because that's also a firstborn. So when you say firstborn, we don't know like what we're referring to, unless we have words from the pasuk.
Cesarean doesn't have it before.
Cesarean is not, right. So, okay, so Yaitzi Daifen, a cesarean. Baba Achrav, and the animal that's born after it. Both of them are a suffix bechar.
What's a suffix in a cesarean?
Could be it's bechar ledavar echad. Could be it's a bechar. It's not the
firstborn.
Right.
Is a firstborn cesarean considered bechor for the kohen?
There's only one. If there's only one baby in there, then he got a cesarean. He's not a bechar. So what's
really? Is that 100%?
It's Peter
Recha.
Not Peter
Stomach,
Peter
Recha. Right. So what's the chat in the
animal?
I don't know.
Different. That's why.
Yeah, Bechor Leleda. Tarfin holds not.
Yeah, but somebody told me that
Tarfin holds not.
No,
okay. So Shnei Mirat, so both of them are a suffix. You have to wait till they get a mum. V'yechle b'mum and labailim, and then the owner can eat it. The owner can eat it that has a mum. Sorry?
Tarfin holds in that
way. But Tarfin holds that both of them are a suffix.
If it's a cesarean.
If it's a cesarean, is a Bechor. Right. What does he do with the pasuk? I don't know. Rabbi Kiva Imer, Shneim Einam Bechar. Rabbi Kiva says, no, they're both not a Bechar. Why? Harishim Pnei Sheinu Petarechem. The first one is not a Bechar because it didn't open the womb. And Vasheni Pnei Shekad Ma'acher. The second one is not a Bechar. It opened the womb, but it's not a firstborn. Okay. But Maika Miflagi, what is the Machlekes here between Rabbi Tarfon and Rabbi Kiva? Rabbi Tarfon, Mesafkele, Bechar Ledavar Echad Yavi Bechar. Ilai Yavi Bechar. So Rabbi Tarfon says that the fact is that the second one opened the womb. So he doesn't explain why the Peter Rechem. He's only explaining that he's a Bechor. You see, here's the thing. You could be a Bechor, that's the confusing thing here, is that you could be a Bechor for one aspect. The firstborn to come out of the womb. But he's not the firstborn of the mother, because there was a cesarean first. So Reb Tarfon says that a Bechor ledavar echad, even a Bechor in one aspect is also a Bechor. So that means that this second animal could be the Bechor because it's the first one to open the womb. Rabbi Kiva pshitale. Rabbi Kiva says no. Bechor ledavar echad layav a Bechor. Rabbi Kiva says that a Bechor for one aspect is not a Bechor. You need to be a full Bechor.
Be both.
It has to be both. It has to open the womb, and it has to be the firstborn. Itana Rabbanan, the rabbis taught in a braisa. We know that there's such a thing as a klal uprat. Klal uprat tells me that it says, if someone brings a sacrifice, mina behema, brings from the animals, mina bakar, mina tzayin, from the cattle and from the sheep. So which animal, the klal was from the animal, which animals, bakar and tzayin. So why did it say behema? Mm-hmm. Oh, it's coming to include something else. Behema tells me it's an inclusion. It's a klal. It's coming to tell that's a klal uprat. Mm-hmm. But sometimes I have a klal hatzarich leprat, which is not what I said, mm-hmm. And we also have a prat hatzarich leklal, which is also not what I. It's not coming to exclude based on it just says you're more general. It's not doing that. It's not just saying more general. It's actually explaining what the what it's referring to. So, miklal atzarich leprat, miprat atzarich leklal ketzad. How do you have this? So the first line of this Gemara, Rashi says, is not part of this discussion. It's going to be the second line that we're going to have. It says, kadosh li kol bechor. It says, sanctify for me all firstborn. Yachal afilu nekeva. Doesn't say male or female. Yachal afil in the cave of Bimashma. Maybe it's also including a female. Talmud Leimer Zachar. Pasuk says, Kadoshti Kol Bechor, got the Korechem, how does it go? Where does the Zachar in
it?
Yeah, Ashiyah Lecha Zacharim LaHashem. So, it says the word Zachar. Okay. It needs to be a male. Okay, now here goes our Klal HaTzarech Leprat. I Zachar, if it would just be a, if it says a male, Yachal Afilu Yatsa Nekeva Lefanav. Maybe the firstborn male, maybe the firstborn male is the firstborn. Mm-hmm. That means if this animal has an older,
is this Mishnah
referring to animals or referring to firstborn animals? Referring to animals. Let's say firstborn, it was a female, and the second one is a male, so we'll say that the male is the firstborn male. That's the Bechor. So Talmud Leimer Peterechem says the opening of the womb. The male wasn't the opening of the womb. So this Peterechem goes back to tell me when it says firstborn, what type of firstborn I needed. Peterechem is a detail, it's a klal hatzarech leprat. The Bechor, which is a klal, needs Peterechem to explain what type of klal I'm dealing with. Okay, Peterechem, if it's the opening of the womb, then yachal afilu yatza acher yetzi daifen. Then maybe, even if an animal came out first as a cesarean, Talmud Leimar Bechor. And I didn't finish the sentence. One came out as a cesarean, then one came out naturally. I'll say, oh, came out naturally, it's a Bechor. It's the opening of the womb, if Peterechem is so serious. So Talmud Leimar Bechor says, no, it needs to be the firstborn. Now we're going to have a little bit of an issue here, because when it says Bechor here, what's that telling me? Well, maybe Bechor only means one Bechor in one detail. Talmud Leimar Bechor comes to tell me Bechor, and this is the opening of the womb. This is the firstborn. Back to the translation of Bechor, what does Bechor mean? What do they call the deconstructionist? You know, like when you say Bechor, what is it? What does Bechor mean? So, if Bechor means anything that has any sort of firstborn, then we did nothing here. It must be that Bechor means you need to be a full Bechor. And therefore, just the fact that you open the womb doesn't mean that you're a Bechor unless you're 100% Bechor. Okay, Amar of Sharvia la Abaya. Sharvia says to Abaya, Reisha, when you look at the middle case, here it calls it the Reisha, because the first case we said wasn't counted in this discussion. If you look at this middle case over here of maybe if a female came out first and the second born was a male, that male should be considered a Bechor. Like Kanasav Le Talmud Bechor. The Gemara could have said, maybe a female that's born, and then a male comes afterwards, because it says Zachar, that should be the firstborn. Talmud Leimar Bechor. No, I need to have the firstborn. The Gemara didn't do that. What did the Gemara do? It said Peterechem. Why didn't it say Talmud Leimar Bechor? No, I need to have a firstborn. The reason is because Bechor wouldn't have told me that, because Bechor could be a firstborn male. So the word Bechor doesn't mean what you think it means. Bechor could mean just a male, and then Bechor wouldn't have told me anything. Alma Bechor ledavar echad havi Bechor. Why didn't the Gemara use that? Because Bechor ledavar echad, one aspect of it is good enough. However, Seifa, Kanasav letalmud Bechor. In the Seifa we said, well, if it needs to be Peterechem, then maybe if there's a firstborn female that came out, maybe if there's a Yaitza Daifen, maybe if there's a cesarean and then afterwards there's a male that's born naturally, so we would say that should be the firstborn, so we should say that was the Peterechem. We say, no, it needs to be the Bechor. So all of a sudden, Bechor doesn't mean one aspect, even though this is a Bechor for one aspect. Bechor has to be everything Bechor. So we switched right in the middle, in front of our eyes, you changed the definition of Bechor. Alma Bechor l'davarach l'yavi Bechor. That's Rav Sharvia's question. Amalei, so Abaya redoes this brisa. Says really, you need to be a bechar in all aspects. That's the translation of the word bechar. Vereisha hachi kamer. This is what it means. Izachar. If the pasuk says zachar, and I'm going to take that literally, it needs to be a male. Yachal afilu yitzad daifen. Maybe a zachar, even if it's born by a cesarean. Talmud leimar peterechem. In other words, Bechar ledavar echad is not a Bechar. So really, if I wanted to get the explanation of a firstborn male that comes after the female, for that, I could have used the word Bechar, that it's not a Bechar, because it's not the firstborn. It's only the firstborn male, that's not enough. So why did it say that we're going to learn this from Peterechem? I could have used the word Bechar. So Abaya says that's not what we're learning from Peterechem. We're learning from Peterechem is that the zachar, the firstborn male, needs to come out of the womb. That's what I use Peterechem for. But Bechar, that word Bechar, that could have taught me that the firstborn male that comes after the female is not a Bechar. In other words, what our Brisa looks like is not really what it's saying. That's what Abaya is doing. Ravina Amar, Ravina says the opposite. Any sort of Bechar is the translation of the word Bechar in the Torah. Again, we're looking at the word Bechar in the Torah. We're discussing what does the Torah mean when it says Bechar. The Seifa Hachikamah. And this is what the Seifa means to say. The problem is that if Bechar L'davarachad is a Bechar, then why? How could the Seifa say, oh, if opening of the womb is the Bechar, then maybe... Even if it comes after a cesarean, so this is the opening of the womb, it should be a Bechar. Talmud Leimar Bechar. Comes to tell me Bechar, no, it needs to be a firstborn. The problem is, it is a firstborn. It's the opening of the womb. What are you telling me, Talmud Leimar Bechar?
We have a raya from Marcus Becharis that there were multiple Becharim from different fathers by the same mother. Obviously, they weren't all called Peterechems. So right. You can have multiple Becharim. And this is for a cow. I'm just saying, it shows you the Lashon Bechor does not equate with Peterechem. And therefore, you need
when it
both.
Comes to killing a goy, you don't go according to Shofanot, you just kill him.
Give me a break. You see what my question is?
Yeah. See, what's happening is you're asking a question on the Gemara based on a Medrash that explains
we're
working out what the Psukim mean. And the Medrash is also working out what the Psukim mean. So granted, when we're done with this, we can then compare it to the Medrash.
Okay.
But we're preceding that.
I didn't realize it was Medrash. I thought it was real.
No, in the text it doesn't say that. Uh-huh. It says the firstborn. You can still discuss it in the text, like which firstborn, what's the firstborn.
It says even the oldest in the house would die. Gain bias a shame sham mace.
Right.
Even if it wasn't a Bechor, it would die.
Yeah, and then we know that it has Bechor, that...
Yeah, even if they weren't Bechor,
the Rebbe explains
in the house.
By Yaakov and Esav that Yaakov is the firstborn to Yitzchak.
Oldest in the house would die.
But Esav is the firstborn to Rivka. Because fatherhood starts from conception, even though he doesn't feel like a father until the baby and the mother, but in feelings it's not like that. But motherhood would start from birth. And so Yaakov, that's why the Medrash says it's like they put in something into a tube, the one that comes out first is the one that comes out second. It's because that has to do with fatherhood. That's why Yaakov is the firstborn to Yitzchak. Okay, so again, there's
okay,
all of this. But we have to explain if Bechar means even Davar Echad, so then how did he use Bechar to tell me that that it can't be the one that comes after the Yotze Daifin. It can't. It's the first natural birth. Why isn't that a Bechar? It's a Hachikamer. Isal Kedaita. So what Ravina is going to do is going to say, the word Bechar doesn't tell that to me. You're right. Because Bechar can mean anything. What's happening with the word Bechar is that the word Bechar is totally extra. It's the extraness of Bechar. It's not the translation of Bechar. If you would say that the baby that's born naturally, the first natural born baby, is the Holy One, so why does it need to say the word Bechar? Now we have to follow through. If it's coming to tell me, why does, if Bechar is telling me that it's coming to tell me that it, that if there was a female that was born first, that this one is not the Bechar, that mi peterechem nafka, that we already know from peterechem, the female opened the womb, this didn't open the womb. Ela shema mina, it's coming to tell me, that word is extra, shema mina Bechar lemutehecha diyotzach yetzdeifen, that extra word is coming to tell me that even though it's the natural, first natural one, but it's still, it's not the Bechar, it's not the firstborn, it's from the extraness, it's not from the translation.
The word Bechar,
according to Ravina, means even Dabar Echad.
No, but I'm saying the word itself is Meutei, a female, because it should say Bechara.
No.
So how do you exclude a female?
We didn't exclude a female here, except that because it says Hazacharim, so I know that I'm only looking for the firstborn male. Mm. So I could have thought that maybe if there's a female born, and then it says the male. So, but it's not the Peterechem, so... Yeah. Okay, Amalei Ravachem Yidifti LaRavina. Ravachem Yidifti says to Ravina, it's not so simple here. It's not so simple. You're making it all, you're throwing everything into one case and saying that's how it is. There's more cases here that haven't been discussed. Isal Kedaitach Bechar LaDavarech Ravi Bechar. If the Torah would say Bechar, meaning any sort of Bechar. So Teinach Echad Yatzah Zachar Daifen. Derech Daifen, it's supposed to say. If a male is born through cesarean. And then there's a male that's born naturally, the light kaddish, that the second one isn't sanctified. Why? The imit leidem mi bechar, because I have an extra word bechar. And the bechar l'rachmim ikka, bechar l'zcharim leka. This is not the firstborn male. I have a firstborn male before. Elehechad yotzen nekeva derech daifen. But let's say... It makes it complex. Let's say there was a female that was born cesarean. B'zachar derech rechem. So I have a firstborn natural male. Likadesh. It should be sanctified. If we're going to say that b'char means even one item, you can't say that. It must be like Abaya says that Bechar means it needs to be, everything needs to be a Bechar. It needs to be a full Bechar. That Bechar needs to be in all areas of Bechar. Mm-hmm. And so that's why this won't work.
Okay.
Abaya
restructured
the whole
book. You say Amar Bavala every day?
Abaya restructured the whole book.
Yeah.
You don't say Amar as well?
No. Because I